bear with us a couple minutes. We're waiting for Chairman Kerry Benninghoff to arrive. And we're waiting for some freshman members to get in their seats and arrive. I'm just saying. I just noticed.
You beat Kerry and you're good.
Yeah. Morning, everybody. Maybe they didn't hear me, Kerry. What do you think? Good morning, everybody. I call the meeting of the House Transportation Committee to order. This meeting is being broadcasted and recorded. Mackenzie, can you please take roll? Make sure you say hi to all your folks at home, the same thing we did last time, all right?
Hi, folks. Chairman Nielsen.
Here.
Bellman. Curry.
Designation.
Hohenstein. Markosik. McAndrew.
Designation.
McNeil. Mullins. O'Mara. Piscitano.
Designation.
Rossi. Schusterman.
Here.
Siegel.
Here.
Warren. Chairman Benninghoff.
Here.
Cabell.
Designation.
Devonzo. Labs.
Designation.
Ortizai.
Designation.
Schurin.
Here.
Schmidt. Smith.
Designation.
Stambaugh.
Here.
Schruzy. Warner.
Designation.
We have a quorum. The first item on our agenda today is Senate Bill 799, introduced by Senator Greg Rothman. I move to consider Senate Bill 799. Is there a second? Representative Hohenstein. Kyle, can you please give us a brief summary of the bill? And Shelley Labs has just joined us virtually. Good morning, Shelley. Representative Labs. Shelby, I got you.
Senate Bill 799 by Senator Greg Rothman. Previously, Act 89 of 2013 allocated an additional $5 million per year out of the Motor License Fund to counties for the construction and reconstruction of county-owned bridges. This bill allows counties to use their existing allocation for the construction and reconstruction of bridges owned by municipalities within the county. This bill passed the Senate by a vote of 50-0 on October 4, 2023. This bill is supported by the Pennsylvania State Association of Boroughs. There is no opposition, and there is one amendment filed to the bill.
Thank you, Kyle. And I offer Amendment A03859 and move to adopt Amendment A03859. Is there a second? Representative Bellman. Kyle, can you please give a summary of the amendment?
Amendment A03859 by Chairman Ed Nielsen. This amendment inserts language clarifying that for the purposes of this program, the City of Philadelphia is considered a county. As a result of the Philadelphia Consolidation Act of 1854 and Section 13 of Article 9 of the State Constitution, the City of Philadelphia and the County of Philadelphia are the same legal entity. This amendment is supported by the City of Philadelphia.
Thank you. I asked the members to support this amendment. Last summer, I met with officials of the City of Philadelphia to discuss some of the problems with this program for county-owned bridges. The issue that the City of Philadelphia currently owns 158 bridges. Since the inception of this program in 2013 under Act 89, PennDOT's determination is that 157 of those bridges are not eligible for this funding because they're owned by a city, not by a county. However, everybody in the capital and everybody in the state of Pennsylvania knows the city of Philadelphia and the county of Philadelphia are the same legal entity. In 1854, the General Assembly enacted the Philadelphia Constitution Act, which merged all municipalities within the county of the city of Philadelphia. In 1952, an amendment to the state constitution abolished all county offices and transferred the responsibilities to the city government. Today, there are no county government in Philadelphia. This means that PennDOT is wrong. 157 bridges owned by Philadelphia are actually county-owned bridges and should be eligible for this program. I appreciate everyone's support on this amendment. Are there any other comments or questions in regards to the amendment? Chairman Benninghoff.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, I'm assuming this money comes out of the liquid fuels money, which obviously causes me pause. For those of us who live in rural areas, I'm curious, what is the total increase to Philadelphia under this amendment? And more specifically, do we have any delineation of what the impact is going to be in all the other counties of the Commonwealth? I respect what you want to do and understand the needs of other communities, but this discussion of whether they're actually a county by legal terminology, I think, is a new concept for the rest of the members here, and this is a could be a significant impact on current projects and those that are slated in rest of the state. So I'd like to know, number one, what total increase to Philadelphia will be and what the impact on the other districts across the Commonwealth. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
No problem. I'll try and answer your question. The question's quite simple in my eyes. Philadelphia and the five-county area and Allegheny pay 46% of the entire state's budget. The entire state's budget, that's liquid fuels, that's everything, okay? And we get less than 20% in return. Let's be fair here. We pay 46% of the entire budget, likely even more when it comes to liquid fuels tax. However, there is an impact, and it is a $700,000 impact, Mr. Chairman. I believe that was your question, but I want to make certain that we know this is Philadelphia's money going into this fund. This isn't just rural PA. So we should be just as entitled to being able to apply for these funds as any other county in the Commonwealth.
I respect your answer. I still have concerns with it, considering I've not had a single endorsement of doing this at this juncture, specifically with this bill. It might be worthy to introduce a standalone bill if this is something you feel that strongly about, that we could actually have some hearings and discussions to see where it's going, because it seems like a pretty big major policy change, and the fact that I have personally not heard from anyone else endorsing this, I'm a little bit suspect to support it at this juncture. Thank you.
Yeah. Any other comments or questions? Seeing none, can we have a roll call vote, please?
Chairman Nielsen?
Aye.
Bellman? Curry?
Designation, yes.
Hohenstein? Markosik?
Yes.
McAndrew?
Designation, yes.
McNeil? Mullins?
Yes.
O'Mara?
Designation, yes.
Piscitano?
Designation, yes.
Rossi? Schusterman, Siegel, Warren, Chairman Benninghoff.
No, thank you.
Cabell.
No designation.
Devonzo.
No.
Labs.
No designation.
Ortizai.
No by designation.
Schurin.
No.
Schmidt. No. Smith.
No by designation.
Stambaugh.
No.
Struzzi.
No.
Warner.
No by designation.
The amendment has been adopted, 14-10. Thank you all. We're now on Senate Bill 799 as amended. I ask the members to support the bill. Are there any comments or questions on the Senate Bill 799 as amended? Chairman Benninghoff.
Just quickly, I'd like to reiterate what I said. While I support the concept of this underlying bill, it does put us in a conundrum of not supporting the amendment and then wanting to support the bill. At this juncture, again, I think this idea that you have is meritorious for your area, and I know that you're trying to support your own community. I think there's probably further discussion needs to be had by those within the PennDOT department and some of our members as far as the legitimacy of whether or not they really consider this, and frankly, whether the totality is actually 700,000 or could be more than that. I actually thought I saw other figures, but I'm not going to argue that with them. With that, I am going to vote no to the bill as amended. I would have voted for the bill otherwise. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. And the just for the record, $782,677.67. That is the exact number that has been calculated. And the question here is not about the money portion of it. It's, is the city of Philadelphia and the county of Philadelphia the same? One and the same. And that certainly has to do when it comes to funding projects across this Commonwealth, which is a direct reflection of this bill. Any other comments or questions? Seeing none, McKenzie, can you please take roll?
Chairman Nielsen?
Yes.
Bellman? Curry?
Designation, yes.
Hohenstein?
Yes.
Markosik? McAndrew?
Designation, yes.
McNeil? Mullins? O'Mara?
Designation, yes.
Piscitano?
Designation, yes.
Rossi? Schusterman? Siegel? Warren? Yes. Chairman Benninghoff?
No as amended.
Cabell?
No by designation.
Devonzo?
No.
Labs?
Yes.
Ortizai?
No by designation.
Shurin?
No.
Smith?
No by designation.
Stambaugh?
No.
Struzzi? Warner?
No by designation.
Listen. The bill passes 15-9 in a bipartisan manner, so we keep our committee record going. All right? Listen, we're doing good here. Thank you, Representative Labs, for doing the right thing. I appreciate you. She might be the next chair if I have anything to say.
Is that majority or minority?
Wow. It doesn't matter because we work in a bipartisan manner.
In the day of being so creative, I thought I'd just ask.
All right. So, okay. Let's see. We're good. All right. Next item on our agenda is House Bill 2177, introduced by Representative Kyle Mullins. I move to consider House Bill 2177. Is there a second?
I will second that in a bipartisan manner.
Where's our legal counsel? Do I have to accept that? Can I get it from somebody else? Oh, you're right in front of me, Lam. He said it first. I got to go with it. All right, it's on film. All right. In a bipartisan manner, I will take the second of Chairman Benninghoff. Thank you.
Here to help.
Kyle, can you please give a summary of the bill?
House Bill 2177 by Representative Kyle Mullins. This bill updates the current schedule for motorcycle safety inspections by replacing it with an annual inspection that is valid for 1 year from the month of inspection. Currently, motorcycles can only be inspected between the months of March to October. This bill allows motorcycles to be inspected any time of the year for a period of 1 year in the same manner as passenger vehicles. This bill is supported by the Pennsylvania Automotive Association, Abate, and by PennDOT with an amendment. There is no known opposition, and there is one amendment filed to the bill.
Thank you. And I call up Amendment A03889, offered by Representative Kyle Mullins. I move to adopt Amendment A03889 in a bipartisan manner. Chairman Benninghoff will second it.
Gladly.
Kyle, can you please give a summary of the amendment?
Amendment A03889 by Representative Kyle Mullins. This amendment makes a technical change requested by PennDOT.
I would like to recognize Rep. Kyle Mullins on his amendment.
Thank you, Chairman. Bipartisan and plural. So thank you. I appreciate you moving this bill and
the input from PennDOT regarding this technical amendment. Simply put, this is a common sense measure, something that we often get to do as lawmakers is understanding a gap or a provision in law that just doesn't make sense to restrict motorcycle safety inspections to only a certain number of months is, I believe, outdated, and we should go ahead and pass this bill. You're probably all scratching your heads thinking, I never took Mullins as a motorcycle guy. And I don't have a motorcycle, but I've got a whole bunch of constituents, friends, and family who do ride and who also often wonder what I'm doing to get rid of laws that don't make any sense. So hopefully today we're checking all of those boxes, and I really appreciate the opportunity to work with the stakeholders and this committee to get it moved through. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative. Are there any other questions or comments on the amendment? We're still on the amendment. Seeing none, are there any negative votes on the amendment? Seeing none, the amendment is adopted. We are now on House Bill 2177 as amended. Again, Rep. Mullins, if you would like to speak, you can. We're good. Anybody else on the bill as amended? Seeing none, I guess everybody support the bill. Are there any negative votes on House Bill 2177 as amended? Seeing none, House Bill 2177 is unanimously reported as amended. So the final item on the agenda is what packed our house today, is House Bill 2184, introduced by myself. We're going to go over the bill today, so we will not be voting on it. But I want to take a few minutes to present this proposal to the committee. We've seen it. We've had hearings on it. And 2184, a lot of hard work was put into it from groups all around the Commonwealth, stakeholders, people, owners, manufacturers. We worked on it hard to come up with something that was reasonable. On December 11th of 2023, the committee reported out of this committee, Senate Bill 656 by Senator Greg Rothman, without amendment. That bill would have established a flat annual electric fee of $290. During that meeting, I said I opposed that bill in its current form, and I stand by that position, and I oppose that in its current form today. The current highest fee now is New Jersey, which was just enacted, a controversial fee starting at $250 and eventually increasing to $290, but not until 2028. Pennsylvania should not have the highest fee in the country. Despite my opposition, I voted to support Senate Bill 656 out of this committee to advance the discussions in hopes we can come up with a negotiated product at the end. Those talks have resumed. I can report that here today. And hopefully between the House and Senate leadership teams, we can come up with a reasonable electric vehicle bill that is fair to everybody across the Commonwealth. With that, I believe I think enough's been said on it. I have plenty. I have a whole book here, so Kyle keeps me on point to make certain. But I want to thank everybody for coming today, and thank the chairman for keeping our bipartisanship alive in the committee. And that wouldn't happen without you. And it's a lot of work, I got to say. We work hard together, the staffs and all of us in here. And I appreciate you all. Thank you, and enjoy the week. This meeting is. Oh, Chairman, you have anything you want to say good to committee?
In a bipartisan manner, we'll
yes,
just
sir.
Make a motion to
I'll second that motion. This meeting is.
All those in favor?
All in favor? We're good. Thank you, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your week. Thanks, Chairman. Yeah.